Hi, my name is Samira Briongos, and I'm going to present our work, Reload and Refresh, Abusing Cash Replacement Policies to Perform Stealthy Cash Attacks. This is a joint work with Pedro Malagón, José Moya, and Thomas Eisenbarth. So the development of cash attacks has led to the development of countermeasures against these attacks. But can we trust these countermeasures? If we assume no changes in the hardware and we assume no preemptive countermeasures, to answer this question, we need to analyze detection-based countermeasures. These countermeasures use the information from performance counters to create behavioral models of the processes they want to protect. In the case of cache attacks, since they generate a huge number of cache misses, they use the information about cache misses to detect the attacks. But can the attacker gain information from the cache without forcing misses? The answer seems to be yes, but only if the eviction of the data depends on the utilization of the data. And this is why we focus on the replacement policy, because it is the algorithm that decides which element is going to be evicted from the cache in case of conflict. And in particular, we focus on the last level cache. The idea to retrieve the replacement policy is to mimic in software the behavior of the hardware. And this is possible because we know the location of each memory block in the cache. We can enforce the order of the accesses and measure times, meaning we can distinguish between cache hits and cache misses. And this is how we conducted several experiments. We first defined a replacement policy we wanted to test and generated two different eviction sets. And then we filled the cache with the data in one of those eviction sets. We randomly access that data and update the parameters of the replacement policy we are testing accordingly. Finally, we have to force a miss. And then we check if the block that was truly evicted from the cache is the one that the replacement policy we are testing had predicted. As a result, we were able to make the following observations about the replacement policy in the processors. First, data is linearly inserted in the cache set. Second, only accesses to the last level 3 cache update the edges of those blocks. And it seems there are two different replacement policies. Fourth and fifth generation seem to implement an adaptive replacement policy, whereas 6, 7, and 8 generations apparently have a fixed replacement policy. But indeed, the replacement policy is just the same. In all cases, they evict the block whose age is equal to 3. They only differ in the insertion age of these blocks. Let me try to give more information about how this works. So whenever the processor requests a piece of data from the cache, it will first try to retrieve from the cache. If the data is in the level 1 or level 2 caches, the processor gets the data. And if it's in level 3, it also has to decrease the age of that memory block. If the data is not in the cache, then data is retrieved from main memory and it has to be placed in the cache. The first thing we check is that if there is an empty block in the cache. If so, then that location is used to place the data and the data is inserted with its corresponding insertion edge. If there is no room, then the replacement policy first check for the first block whose age is equal to 3. Whenever it has one block whose age is equal to 3, that block is replaced with the new one. And the age of the new one is its corresponding insertion age. So answering to our previous question, in Intel processors, the order of the eviction depends on both the location of the data inside the set and the order or the actual utilization of the data. And this is why we were able to define our attack to create reload and refresh. That allows us to retrieve information from the cache without forcing cache misses on the victim. And we say we abuse the replacement policy because with this knowledge, we can place the data into the cache in the desired location and manipulate its age. And just by observing changes in the eviction candidate, we can distinguish between accesses or not accesses of the victim. And to carry this attack, we assume that there is shared memory, that an attacker can construct an eviction set, and ensure the order of the accesses. And let me illustrate how this works. Reload and refresh also has different stages as any other cache attack. First, we have to prepare the cache. We have to place the target on the first position of the set and then fill the set with our own data. Then we wait for the victim to access the data. And then if the victim accesses the data, the age of the target decreases and the victim candidate changes. If not, everything remains the same. Then we have to retrieve the information. And to do so, we first force a miss, which means that the age of all the elements first is increased. And then we access one memory location that also maps to this cell. So some data is evicted and the evicted candidate changes again. Now, just by reloading the target information, the target data, we can know if the victim has or has not used the data. Note that in one case, the age of the target decreases, and in other case, one block is evicted and the victim candidate changes again. Finally, we have to refresh the cache state, meaning we have to bring back the cache state to how it was. First, the location of the target has to be the first one, and the block we have used to create the conflict has to be removed from the cache. So we remove both from the cache, access the target, and access the original block that was evicted in the first state. And then we access the remaining elements to refresh their ages, and the eviction candidate becomes a target again. So with the information of these attacks and all the extra steps, we have evaluated its performance and compare it to existing approaches such as flash and reload and prime and probe. And we have evaluated our attack in covert channel scenario. And as you can see in the table, the performance of the attacks in terms of accuracy is similar, but our attack has lower resolution, meaning that the extra steps we use to avoid detection reduce the resolution of the attack. But our attack is still, it can still be used for cryptanalysis. Meaning, and we demonstrate that by retrieving an AES secret key with similar performance that any other approaches, but with no cache misses, as you can see in the bottom graph. We also retrieve the sequence of the execution of multiply operations in an RSA decryption. And as you can see also, in this case, the number of cache misses is negligible if we compare it with flash and reload or with prime and probe. We have collected information about our attack and about other attacks from different performance counters. And as you can see in the graph, there are results for AES, for RSA in different situations. And there's only one performance counter that is able to distinguish between attack and normal situation in all the cases. And that counter is the level 2 instruction misses counter. But this is a tricky counter because we don't really know what is the effect of any other benign application sharing the same core as the victim, sharing the same core with the victim application, right? So our work shows an important limitation in detection algorithms. Since the number of counters that a detection algorithm can use is limited, they have to perform a selection. And an attacker with great knowledge of the microarchitecture can just hide the effect of the attack to this particular set of counters, meaning that the attacker can just bypass detection countermeasures this way. We also provide further details about the cache architecture with the replacement policy or the description of the replacement policy we provide. Any other attack, any other cache attack could benefit from this knowledge. Finally, I would like to say that there is a proof of concept of the attack available in GitHub, and you also have there my contact information. Feel free to contact anytime. And that's all. Thank you for your attention, and I will be happy to take all your questions now.